Again to my channel. My name is Christine Okosun. Today I'll be doing another reaction to Elvis Presley. The first time I heard it, I must admit I was so shocked. I'm actually on a journey to studying the old, because the old have the best vocal technique, have the best musicianship ever, and yes, and Elvis Presley is one person that I would always want to listen to, because he actually has a very good technique. So like I always say, let's talk more reaction. I'll be doing my reaction to his performance of Bridge Over Troubled Waters. Let's see how this goes. I love he has this vocal agility, like when he did it, like a bridge. It wasn't forced, it was so clear, like he's talking. And he has serious vocal agility, despite the fact that he has a big timbre, a dark timbre. I'm wondering if he's baritone, but obviously this doesn't sound like a tenor voice to me. The vocal agility is amazing. I don't know, I've not read much about him, but I wouldn't be surprised if he was classically trained. I want to go back a bit. Vocal agility. Then when he was singing the source part, you can still hear it. This guy is good. I really love the old. There's a lot to learn from them. If you want to be a good singer, listen to the old. Did you get that? See the distance. See the distance of the mic. And you can still hear the sound. You can still, his voice is actually filling the whole atmosphere. I don't know if he has ever done any a cappella. If you watch my first reaction, he's not so popular here in Nigeria. Let me just say Nigeria. I'm gonna go to the streets, and I hope they don't steal my phone and start asking people if they know Elvis Presley, so you understand what I'm saying. Now, see, I love the volume. Let me just enjoy this thing, then I will just enjoy his performance, then I'll put the rest of the screen. It's a learning thing for me because, like I said, if one learns too much, it's enough. Sorry, I have to show what I'm hearing here. You don't need to look at a projector or anything to understand what he's saying, because he articulates his words very well. I won't mention most of the singers we have these days. You can't even hear anything. His articulation is crisp and clear. Even when he's singing legato, it's very clear what he's saying. He exaggerates the consonants, and you can hear them crisp and clear. And then you can see his jaw is relaxed. And when he's singing those low notes, you can actually see his larynx lowered. If you want to be a good singer, listen to the old. You're really missing out if you listen to this. I don't want to say more than that. Internet over here. Oh my goodness. Did you hear his vibrato? It's not the forced vibrato. It's not the vibrato that is a signal that the voice is actually doing the person in, or the person actually understanding what it is to sing from the right place. His vibrato shows that he's singing from a healthy place. I don't know if he did any a cappella. I would like to hear his a cappella version. You can, because what I'm saying is, because I believe strongly that even with instrument playing and not having that microphone to amplify his voice, that his voice can still carry the sound carry the instrumentalist. Like, you can hear him. What I'm saying is, you can hear him despite the instrumentalist playing, even if he's not holding the microphone. Because from what I can hear, this if you want to learn how to sing properly, please listen to the old. Please listen to the old. Mm-hmm. I'm so excited. Oh my God. Ah, okay. Oh my goodness. Wow, this guy can't sing. I can really sing. Okay, this. Let me get myself. You can see he's in control of the music at a point. He looked at one of the instrumentalists. I guess they're trying to go their own way, and he's conducting the whole thing going on that stage in performance. Yeah, besides, I learned that Whitney Houston's mother was his backup. Wow. You can see his jaw is relaxed. No stiff jaw, none of those artificial coloring that most of these singers imputing their singing by having stage or lower. Nothing like that. Oh my God, this is good. I need to go back a bit. This is, like I said, this is me also learning a lot from the old. Oh my goodness. This guy has good technique. He's not about belting and thinking about. Okay, now look at that part. You can't see any tension here. That part, I will leave your mind, and then you can't hear any pinched sound or squeezed sound. You can't hear any pinched or squeezed sound. And it's so free. This guy sings properly, so well. I don't know what his music background is, but I'll be so pissed off if I knew that he didn't have any formal singing thing, because these are the kind of people that if you have it naturally, I have a big beef for them. But I want to believe he had some form of training, because this can't be just all now. All okay, fine. Some have him, but I think he had training. I want to believe he had some training some time in his past. Did you see the part? Did you see the part? And I love the part they did the triplets with the horns. Let me go back. The part he did the triplets with the horns. Oh my God. His musicianship is so apt. He knows what he wants from the horns. He knows what he wants from the drums. He knows what he wants from the pianist. He's a conductor apart from being a performer. He's the performer and the conductor. He has that energy. He passes the energy to. Sorry, I'm so excited. I can't help it. He's passing the energy to all of them. He's so. His singing and his stage presence is so magnetic and powerful. Sorry, I'm learning a lot from. Okay, let me just shut up and I swear down. I'm gonna listen to this again on my own. Whoa, okay. Okay, if you want to be a serious musician, oh my God, if you want to be a very good singer, and I will at this point dare say if you want to be oh my God, and I should stop calling God's name in vain. He's apart from his stage presence, him fine, maybe because I so much love Mario Lanza. I can also see that kind of magnetic presence in performance, like I get from Mario Lanza, even if Mario Lanza is known for another genre of music. But trust me, I would, if Elvis wanted to do Nessun Dorma, for example, he will nail it. I'm so confident of that. Maybe he wasn't interested in doing that. I like the fact that he doesn't care what people who try to bring the race card for no reason. I don't want to go into that because it's so unhealthy, and I don't need to take Panadol for another person's that's taking ibuprofen for another person's headache. So I really would employ you if you are interested to sing, you want to be a good singer, and you want to your voice to last for you and sing from a healthy place. Learn from the old. And when I say the old, not all of the old are good. Some of them, they do this horrible technique for scientific. For vocalists, I'm so impressed with it's wrong to see the black man in the white man's skin, because no voice is a style of singing or a kind of big voice is not gifted to just one race. God chooses to gift anybody, absolutely anybody, with any kind of gift he desires to give. So that is that. And avoid the new ones that are not good at all. They're actually more. So, Merry Christmas once more. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance. Please stay safe. Stay safe as much as you can. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Hit the notification bell to let you know when I upload a new video. Till we see again, be safe and have a Happy New Year in advance. Bye.